What's up, everyone? Today I'm going to show you an area in Key West that many people overlook, and that's Fort Zachary Taylor State Park. I recorded this video on Friday, July 22nd, 2022. It's 4:30 p.m. and it's 90 degrees Fahrenheit, 32 Celsius. This park is a little bit of a trek from the Old Town area of Duval Street. So you may need to be dropped off here, or you can do what I did and ride your scooter here. Now, admission to the state park is not free. You do need to pay a nominal fee depending on your method of entry and how many people you have. For me, it was $2.50. But this is one of my favorite parks in Florida. We're going to be exploring it right now. I think you're really going to like it. Alcoholic beverages are prohibited. This park is on the southwest corner of Key West, past the Cuba marker, 90 miles to Cuba. I had to take South 3rd Street to get here. There are two very cool areas to visit, the fort and also the beach. I think you'll really like the fort. I've been here once before. And this fort is very historic. No bikes allowed, so what I'll do is I'll lock up my scooter to the This is why this park is named Fort Zachary Taylor, because of this historical marker here. There's also hiking trails available. Some information about the fortification. It was an important defensive structure for the United States. The US Navy had a huge presence here. They still do, as well as the Coast Guard. Rooms. Zachary Taylor also was elected the U.S. president from 1849 to 1850. Take a look at this blacksmith shop. Okay. here we are, Fort Taylor. Complete with Florida's very own iguana. And there's also a moat around the fort, which we're crossing over right now. Comes complete with the cannonballs. See the can that I used before, as well as the gunpowder bags. This one was named Scarlet, range of 2.4 miles at 16 degrees of elevation. Definitely a lot to see around here. Hazardous area. Yeah, it doesn't look very sound. There's cracks all along the walls and the ceiling. Walk through the fort over here though and even go up the stairs. This is so cool. It is so worth coming down here if you're into history like me. And not many can come to Key West and say that they've visited an old fort. Just imagine sticking out your cannon here. How far this goes. Oh, this looks like the corner. There's a view of a tree, but nothing else. Here's a good view. Doesn't look like there's anything over here. Let's go to that staircase and climb it. What's this area? We are at the top of the fort now. Incredible. Here you can see the US Navy and Coast Guard facilities. Great view of the moat. Harbor view. We have to make our way down. I think the only way back down is where we came from. go. No railings on the staircase. This section of the fort is still in good condition. It's also a nice way to walk without getting battered by the sun. This looks like it used to lead to the top of the fort. Battery Adair. This is the last section we can climb. Over there it says caution. Hidden treasure. Look at that. Buried right in the fort. And they just left them like that. Thank you. Oh, it looks like we can go down from there. That caution sign just was a warning that it gets wet. Looks like they're closing up the park. It's 4:58 p.m. At 5 p.m. it looks like they start shutting down. I hope I have enough time to visit the beach, because that beach was incredible. I made it just in time. 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. The 4 hours. Hopefully the beach is close by. I don't really remember if it was or not, but I am going to ride my scooter there. Just hang my bike lock over here. As long as I don't sway it too much, it shouldn't really get in the way.
Hey, you're everywhere.
Hey.
Keep it up.
I'm everywhere, that's right.
Get it.
Looks like it was a good idea for me to ride my scooter here. Beach is to the left. As you can see, they have a great amount of parking here, even RV parking too. The fishing area is straight I'm not going to check out the fishing area because the ground is not paved. But the beach, I can easily check out. I think there's a paved path there. Yep. It's easy. Lock this up over here. To set this down, I need two hands. Okay, now we're ready to see the beach. This is one of my favorite beaches in Florida. I think even a few publications have named this beach the best beach in Key West. There's other ones like Smathers Beach and Higgs Beach as well. Not too many tourists come down here. There is also no lifeguard on duty, so you do have to swim at your own risk. And the beach here is rocky. There's also a snack bar up there. I'll show you the snack bar once I go back up. But for now, just enjoy the tranquil waves. It's a very quiet current. You've got umbrella and chair rentals.
All right, you're all set.
Also bottled water for sale and snorkeling gear.
Right over here.
I wonder if the snack bar is open right now, considering it's past 5 o'clock. There's also a mini gift shop, but looks like they turned the lights out there. So you can see the prices here are pretty reasonable considering it's Key West. $10.25 for a hamburger, $13.25 Cuban sandwich, also ice cream and beverages, even alcohol. Kitchen closes at 5, so they're done for the day. I knew it. This is something cool to see. All the different markers. All right, well, that was my video of Fort Zachary Taylor State Park. If you enjoyed this treasure of a state park here in Key West, in the southwestern corner, then please give me a thumbs up and be sure to consider visiting here if you're ever coming to Key West. Hit that like button and I will see you next time. Bye-bye, everyone. See you soon.